Welcome to the new Sounds of J.W. Pepper, where we'll explore the newest music titles for school and church from the publishers and writers who create them. Each episode, we'll talk with a different publisher or writer about their top new releases for the coming year, along with behind-the-scenes stories and teaching tips that you wouldn't get anywhere else. In this episode, we're talking with Michael Sweeney, director of band publications and composer for Hal Leonard. Mike is going to share some of Hal Leonard's top new releases from their concert band and jazz catalogs for your consideration. Remember to check the YouTube description below, where we'll include links to all the pieces we're discussing today. Hello, Mike, and welcome to New Sounds. Thanks for joining us.
Hi, Andrea. Great to be with you.
Yeah. Oh, this is going to be so much fun. We are talking about lots of different stuff today. We're going to talk about concert band and jazz titles, and I'm excited to get into that. But before we do, let's talk a little bit about Hal Leonard and about what's going on there. So, and this one actually is just more for you, and it's an industry question. So, being that you are a veteran of the print music industry.
Watch how you say that.
Just means you've done this for a while.
I have,
I'm curious about what kind of changes you've seen in the world of instrumental music over the years. How has band music evolved?
Well, that's really an interesting question. I think the music itself really hasn't changed that much. You take a piece written, a quality piece from 20 or 30 years ago, sounds just as fresh and as valid today as it did then. I think you're seeing a little more interest in diversity and also various types of world music, which I think is great. And then, of course, the flex band, which we've had many years even before the pandemic, but it's a lot more needed now. So that's one thing that we've adapted to. But the music itself, quality music is still quality music, and we take it from there.
Yeah, no, I think that's great because you're absolutely right. The delivery and how we get our music and, you know, how we read it and the different types of ensembles. Yeah. I mean, that's definitely changed, but you're right.
Really, yeah, the big change is the technology and the editing and the engraving. And like you say, the delivery, that has just changed so much.
Well,
but the music.
Go ahead.
Music is still the music.
Exactly. No, you're totally right. I mean, and that leads me perfectly into our next question. So Hal Leonard does a lot with technology, granted. So how do you see technology impacting ensemble music and how it's offered? Because you guys do offer it in a variety of ways.
Right. Well, as you know, these last couple of years, we were forced to use more technology and adapt to more virtual type settings. But I think in the end, band music and performance music in general is really meant to be enjoyed in person and with people side by side. So as good as we get at the technology, there's no substitute for being in a classroom, in a band, in an ensemble, and performing. So yeah, we do have a lot of technology. I think where it can be really useful, at least from my perspective, is the beginning band and the band methods, mm-hmm. where we have the essential elements interactive. We have so much videos and recording and audio and auxiliary information that's updated constantly. And that's the type of thing where a kid can use it at home or a teacher can use it in the classroom. So that's where I think technology really shines is with the Essential Elements Interactive. Little plug, if you're using Essential Elements, it's totally free. And I think people sometimes don't take advantage of the resources that are out there. Mm-hmm. So I'd encourage anyone that hasn't, take a look at it.
Well, and that's another thing you mentioned, free resources, because I know Hal Leonard was one of the first companies to do the score play video. And in fact, I think that's what you call them. And now a lot of people call them that too.
Yes. It's our YouTube channel where you can, and which is what we're going to see today, I guess, when mm-hmm. we're showing the new music.
Yeah. I mean, it's just kind of revolutionized how music is presented to customers.
Right.
You know, and I know that from a retailer perspective, we love that. I think it's a really easy way to preview music without having to do a reading session and that kind of thing. So yeah.
You remember the old days where we had to look at a paper score to see what was going on?
I can't imagine we even could do it. Yeah, anyway.
No, I can't imagine going back.
How did we do that?
I don't know. Anyway. Let's not go back.
So So tell us more about what's new at Hal Leonard. So how has the pandemic made you pivot or reinvent your offerings? Any new series or anything that you want to mention?
Yeah. Well, first of all, the pandemic affected us all and really put the skids on any forward progress for a lot of companies. Mm-hmm. We were forced to do a lot of cutbacks, just cut back in publications. We lost staff members, unfortunately. We couldn't keep all the employees. So it was a severe time for us and a time to really evaluate what we were doing. So in the band area, one thing we severely scaled back the number of publications and tried to adapt to what people needed. And that, you know, in many cases, it was easier pieces and more flex band. Mm-hmm. We did create a new easier level of flex band, which we can talk about when we get to that in the music. As far as the writers, we've got an amazing team of writers that we've had for many, many years. So that hasn't changed that much. One new writer I wanted to bring up in the jazz area, Michelle Fernandez. You've probably seen her name.
Yes.
Retired teacher from Miami, fabulous teacher and fabulous writer of authentic sounding jazz, Latin jazz.
So excellent.
Watch for her name. She's got a couple pieces in print already and more to come. So keep an eye out on
good. Good, good, good. We need more female jazz writers. So
yeah, you bet. You bet.
Excellent. All right. Well, with that, should we talk about some music?
Absolutely.
All right. Let's get started. So our first one today, we're just going to start with a Bond piece. So No Time to Die. Tell us about this one.
Well, the timing on that is really good since
it really is.
the movie just came out and I guess is doing really well. I haven't seen it yet.
Me neither.
But the main theme is very Bond-like, recorded and written by Billie Eilish. And she did a great job of coming up with something new, but still a flavor of the Bond sound that we all love. This arrangement is by Michael Brown. Michael has been with us for many years. He's a retired arranger for the U.S. Army Band in Washington, D.C. So, and he really specializes in concert band and is a master at using all of the colors of the wind band and creating something interesting even at easier levels. But this is a grade three, No Time to Die, arranged by Michael Brown.
Okay, well, let's take a listen.
Thank you.
that. It really, for a grade three, it sounds really lush. And I think that's part of the thing with the Bond music. It's always got those hooks, and it's just really...
Oh, yeah. There's the flavor there.
Sound.
Yeah.
And I think this one, a great choice for Spring Pops concerts. So people are starting to think about that now. That will be very timely.
So. Absolutely.
All right. A total change of pace. Rhapsody in Blue for Flex Band.
Absolutely. This is the Gershwin classic composition that brought a flavor of jazz to the symphonic stage. So trying to adapt that massive work to a more of a concise setting was a real challenge. So this is a grade three flex band. A little bit about flex band. It's five parts for the winds, and each of the five parts has an option for brass, woodwind, or strings. So you can really perform it with any combination. You could do a brass ensemble, woodwind ensemble, even strings, or mix and match. And what you'll hear in the demo is more of a full band. So you can play these with a full band, and it'll sound full. As long as you have at least one player on each of those five parts, mm-hmm. the arrangement sounds complete. Uh-huh. And if you have enough players, there are places in the score where it's marked you can play brass only if possible, or woodwinds only if possible. So if you have enough players, you can kind of customize and add some variety rather than just having everybody play all the time. Mm-hmm. This arrangement by Paul Murtha, he's been with us for many years also. He's also a retired arranger, chief arranger for the U.S. Army Band in D.C. He writes in concert band, jazz ensemble, marching band. He's kind of a jazzer at heart, still plays trumpet professionally.
Oh, wow.
So this was a perfect project for him. And he was able to use many of the familiar themes from Rhapsody in Blue and put it into a nice, concise, well-paced arrangement for it's a little on the upper end of grade three, maybe grade three and a half, but flex band nonetheless. And I think you'll enjoy it.
Okay, let's listen. this is a really amazing arrangement. I'm continually just impressed by how full FlexBand sounds. I mean, you honestly, if you didn't know this was FlexBand, you could not tell.
Correct. Yeah, with the variety, and if you have enough players to mix and match, you can add a lot of variety. It's pretty amazing with just the five parts what you can do.
Yeah, and this one specifically, it's so full. I especially loved the flutter tongue options in this one.
Perfect.
It's a little challenging because it has so many style changes and tempo changes, but it gives it a lot of variety, and I think it's a fun one to do.
Well, and having the kids listen to the original and just really kind of point out where all that happens in the original, I mean, could be a really great learning experience. So
sure.
Very cool. Okay, to another wonderful educator, this is Risk Everything for a Dream, Richard Saucedo. Another flex band, though.
Another flex band. Richard Saucedo is a former director of bands at the famed Carmel High School band program in Indiana. He built a tremendous program there, concert band and marching band. The same year that he brought his concert band to perform at the Midwest Clinic was the same year his marching band won Grand Nationals.
Oh my gosh.
That's just an amazing feat. So we're thrilled to have Richard as a part of the team. This piece of his, Risk Everything for a Dream, he did the full band version was back in 2015.
Okay.
And it's dedicated to the United Sound program and its founder, Julie Duty. And the idea, the dream in the title refers to the hope of performing opportunities for special needs students.
Oh.
So it's a special piece, a very touching piece, and he adapted it just this last year for the grade 2 flex band format. So I think you'll enjoy this one.
Yeah, all right, let's listen. And this one, it's just beautiful. It's a short, beautiful, very lush piece. I use that word a lot, but it really
Well, the pacing, too, it really has an emotional flow that I think is appealing to students.
Yeah, it's nice. All right. Again, a total change of pace. Polar Express for flex band.
One thing we do have is variety. It's,
yes, we do.
You know, this is just the tip of the iceberg of what we have available, of course. But I wanted to show different styles, different levels, and different writers. So, yeah, we're kind of bouncing around here style-wise.
It's good. So Polar Express, and you have a variety of arrangements of Polar Express music too. So this one.
Right, right.
This is just the main theme, right?
Correct. It's the main theme arranged by Johnny Vincent. I think it's about 2 minutes or
yeah,
thereabouts.
It's quick.
Johnny Vincent has been writing for Hal Leonard for over 40 years.
Oh, my goodness.
Believe that. He's even longer at it than I am. And he's a former director of bands at Auburn University.
Okay.
A powerhouse program there. But he's really known for his writing for younger level bands and how he can make those bands just sound terrific and full. So he did a great job with this. I guess grade 2 flex band, Polar Express, main theme.
Oh. Okay, here we go. This could be a classic opener. Be just perfect for a holiday concert. If people haven't picked their holiday music yet, or even just for any concert, because it's just a fun piece.
And again, if you have enough players in different sections, you can customize and drop out a few players here to give it some variety and give some players a rest.
Yeah.
And all of these recordings in our Flex band, I think we have over 160 titles now for Flex.
Wow.
They're all on our YouTube channel. You can see and hear all of them, so be sure check those out.
Well, I know Hal Leonard was the pioneer in Flex back in the day. I think I remember when it came out.
Paul Abner and I developed that. I think it was back in 2006 or 2007.
Yeah.
So even then, there was a need for smaller programs that
still
have good players, and it's just hard for them to fill out all the parts. So this was the perfect solution for that type of situation.
Okay, well, let's move to one of your pieces. And this, we were talking earlier, this is what I call a dynasty piece because it started the whole dynasty of Celtic Aran dances. So tell us about this one.
Well, I just don't know when to stop, I guess.
Yeah. What are we on now? Number 5, number 6?
Yeah, I think it may be time to quit. This one came out, the original version, in 2007. And I'm such a fan of traditional Irish music and those wonderful tunes. That it's fun to find old tunes and then treat them slightly differently. I don't know if I ever told you, I play in some of the Irish pubs here in town.
Yes.
The weekly sessions, I play Tin Whistle and Bowron.
I believe I've heard you play.
it's a real obsession that I just can't seem to kick. So this adaptation of Celtic Aran Dance is a part of our new, easier level of Flex. And rather than the 5 parts, this only has 4 parts.
Okay.
So it's even more adaptable for younger levels. We have several in this new level, about a grade 1.5, really designed for probably second or third year players.
Okay.
Not beginners, certainly, but second year players should be able to handle this. So this is the easy flex adaptation of Celtic Air and Dance.
Okay, here we go. That we can still, that this piece still lives on as one of our top sellers every year. Crazy.
It's fun to play, and it's that style of music is really infectious.
It really is. That's why we have like five of them now. Are there five? Are we up to number five?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. I see what's next. And this one. Talk about variety. Shakespeare meets Godzilla. This one, we have seen this on a ton of reading sessions this summer.
And oh, wonderful.
I think people pick it mainly because of the title, because they don't know. Like, that's got to be interesting. We're going to have this one.
Yeah. You always have to be careful when you come up with a clever title. You see clever and catchy titles, and sometimes the music doesn't always live up to the title. But this one, it certainly does.
It does.
Robert Buckley is from Vancouver, Canada, where he's been a very successful TV and film writer for a number of years. But he really loves concert band writing at all levels, from grade one all the way up to grade five. And he brought this piece to us, and we thought it was terrific. On the surface, you think it's just kind of a little novelty mashup of styles, Renaissance and scary movie themes, but there's really a lot of music, a lot going on, a lot you can teach. There's mm-hmm. a lot of substance there. And Robert included a script that kind of describes the story Ooh. That it portrays, that you could either put it in a program, or you could project it on a screen if you like, Or if you don't have that, the music really stands on its own. So if you don't use that, it's still a very entertaining and really quite appealing music to listen to and to play. Robert was particularly proud of his subtitle, The Good Bard and the Ugly.
Oh, good grief.
Takes a little while to settle in. But yeah, he made sure we kept that in the music. But it's really a nice mashup of styles, and I think it'd be a lot of fun for students to play.
Okay, let's listen, and particularly listen to hear both the Shakespeare and the Godzilla part, because they are very distinctive.
All right.
All right, here we go. This piece, I think it could be, this could easily be either a Pops concert or a concert piece. I mean, this is just like a straight up concert festival.
Oh yeah. There's meat on it. There's a lot in there and it's entertaining as well.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Okay. Let's move on to Resilience. I like this one.
Michael Orr, he's currently a very successful band director, middle school band director in Virginia. And he has a great connection with his kids. And so he really understands that age group and what they're able to do and what they enjoy playing. So this piece was really inspired by the pandemic shutdown and just the resilience of the teachers to carry on through that really hard time. So this piece is meant to be kind of an uplifting and upbeat type of piece that hopefully would give kids something fun and enjoyable to play. It's really, I think you'll hear it, it's got an upbeat flavor to it, nice pacing, and I think it would be a good thing to get kids back in the swing of playing together. So a very, very enjoyable piece.
Okay, let's listen to Resilience. One I put on here, Sparkles. I put on my notes. It really does. I mean, from the very beginning, it's just a really energetic, fun piece.
And then the modulation kicks it in to another level.
And there's
level
some
at
mixed meter, you know, goes back and forth from 3/4 to 4/4, and it's got a lot of stuff in it.
So I think you did capture a good flavor of upbeat and uplifting, and I think the title really fits.
Yeah, it's nice. All right. Well, that was our trip through Concert Band. And now let's move to some jazz. You've got three titles to feature here and three very different titles as well.
It was hard to narrow this down from such a catalog of titles. But the first one, Tour de Force, Dizzy Gillespie classic arranged by Michael Mossman. Michael teaches at Queens College in New York City. But he's really known as a Latin master of trumpet and composition. And this is the list of people who he's recorded with and written for. Dizzy Gillespie, Jerry Mulligan, Joe Henderson, Tito Puente, Carnegie Hall Jazz Orchestra, and just many others. So this is a terrific arrangement. It's not really that hard. Kind of a medium grade 4. Features a moderate cha-cha groove, and importantly with Michael's arrangements, all of those authentic rhythm section parts are completely notated, completely written out. Okay. So it's a great model for students to be able to attain that style.
Okay, and the recording is exceptional.
This is real players. Unlike, you probably noticed some of the earlier concert band recordings were MIDI. We were, unfortunately, we had to go that route during the pandemic. Mm-hmm. But jazz, we use real players for jazz. You can't really really hard. So we're gradually getting back in the studio, and I look forward to when we can get back to having live players again.
Oh, absolutely. Let's listen to this guy. Yeah. Let's listen to this one. Tour right. de Force. Change of pace. Sweet Home Chicago, vocal solo. I love the vocal solo series that Hal Leonard has.
Yeah, I wanted to show at least one of these. We do have maybe 50 or 60 in the series now. And Rick Stetzel is a pro at this. He's a retired educator and performer from Texas. He's comfortable at all levels, but for us, he primarily writes the younger pieces. But the vocal solo was one of his standout series as well. But yeah, the Sweet Home Chicago, probably best known by the Blues Brothers. Mm-hmm. But it's a fun piece. And if you don't have a vocalist, you can perform it with a tenor sax.
Oh, okay.
So it's got some options.
Oh, it's great. And the recording on this is great, too. So
It's fun.
All right, let's listen to Sweet Home Chicago.
Sweet Home Chicago. Oh, come on, baby, don't you wanna go? Oh, hey, hey, oh, baby, don't you wanna go? Back to that same old place, Sweet Home Chicago. One and one is two, six and two is eight. Come on, baby, don't you make me late. That same old place, sweet home, Chicago. Come on, baby, don't you wanna go? Yeah, come on, baby, don't you wanna go? Yeah, yeah. Back to that same old place, sweet home, Chicago. Nine is 18. Look there, brother, baby, and see what I've seen, honey. Oh, baby, don't you wanna go back to that same old place, sweet home, Chicago? Come on, baby. That same old place, sweet home, Chicago. Come on, baby, don't you wanna go? Well, come on, baby, don't you wanna go?
This next one has been in my head ever since I listened to it. It will not go away. So let's give it one more shot and then hopefully it's gone. This is My Little Suede Shoes. And this is a Little Big Band arrangement.
Little Big Band. This is a series that's, again, it's been around for 8 or 9 years. Mm-hmm. We started before the pandemic. But even now with some shrinking band programs, I think this is becoming a more popular format. Six horns plus rhythm section. Three saxes, two trumpets, and trombone. There are some optional parts, so you can kind of customize it to fit your own situation. And there are different levels, 3, 4, and 5, so you can find this format for different grade levels. Mark Taylor, the arranger of this, he's been the anchor of our jazz catalog for 30-plus years. He's also former chief arranger for the U.S. Army bands,
wow,
like some of our other folks. And prior to that, he was a staff writer for the Stan Kenton Orchestra.
Oh.
So he knows his stuff, and he is comfortable with the easy charts as well as the hard charts. Mark just does a fabulous job with whatever he touches. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, this is a really entertaining little tune, Charlie Parker classic, a grade 3 Little Big Band on My Little Suede Shoes.
Okay, let's listen.
Thank you.
seriously, it was in my head the entire morning. I just listened to it probably about an hour before we did this, and I cannot get it out of my head. Because I honestly could not remember what tune this was just by looking at the title. I don't know why, because as soon as I heard it, I was like, oh, well, I know this one.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
So many Charlie Parker tunes are very complex, but this is one that is really catchy and really sticks with you, as you
excellent.
Found out.
It's excellent. All right, well, that's it. That's our tour through Hal Leonard, a quick tour of Hal Leonard's newest releases. Mike, do you have any parting comments that you'd like to share with our viewers?
Well, first of all, Andrea, thanks so much for inviting me to be a part of this and J.W. Pepper. It was a lot of fun to do this and to have the opportunity to show a tiny sliver of the new things that we have coming out. Picking music for your program is one of the most difficult things, but it can be one of the most rewarding things, too. Mm-hmm. And I think now in particular, it's important to find whatever you can to keep kids engaged. I mean, it's important to not just go to one style, but mix it up so you engage as many kids as possible. It's important to provide variety. Also, don't be afraid to play some easier pieces than you normally would, just so you can get into the emotion of the piece and maybe get a complete polished performance.
Yeah, this
so it's
year
a challenging
especially.
Time. This year is I know it's a challenge, but the music you pick does have a major influence on the success of your band program. So good luck with every that, and hope everybody has a fantastic year.
Excellent. Excellent. Oh, thank you so much for being here. We really appreciate it. You taking
my
the
pleasure.
Time.
Thank you.
All right. And we will talk to you again soon, I'm sure. Thanks, Mike.
I'm sure. Bye.
To wrap things up, remember the links to the titles we looked at today are in the YouTube description. And you can find all of these titles and more at jwpepper.com. We hope you found this video helpful. We know that picking new music can be tough, and we're here to help. If you did find this video helpful, give us a thumbs up, and be sure to comment below to let us know of any ideas you want to see in future episodes. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any new content we have coming out at JW Pepper. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you next time.